Though the evidence itself has not been revealed, U.S. intelligence is claiming to have proof of China manufacturing nuclear weapons, a blatant infraction of international treaties. China has made an unmitigated denial of the charges, restating the belief that diplomatic talks with China continue to crumble. U.S. military forces are mobilizing towards the anticipation of possible hostilities. China again denies any involvement in Kombayn Nikoladze's... Oh my God. Broadcast through the internet just minutes ago.
Cannot allow my nation to be subjected to the blatant international despotism of the United States or the cronyism of its allies. The world is not yours alone. And the soldiers you send into it are all equally guilty of American fascism. At 5:30 p.m. Greenwich Standard Time, the United States soldiers captured in a just war against their motherland will be executed. Their deaths broadcast for the world to watch.
Mouke Tsoe Bo Meats, Yangon, Myanmar, November 11, 2004, 22:52 hours. Rescue the captured U.S. troops. In a desperate act of defiance against the U.S., Nikoladze arranges the immediate live webcast executions of the captured U.S. soldiers. Vyacheslav Grinko will direct the soldiers' deaths. The executions must be prevented to preserve any hope of stabilizing political relations with the Chinese.
Fisher, we're getting close to war. If Nikoladze kills these men on live broadcast, we're sunk.
Are we worrying about the broadcast or the murders?
For now, the broadcast. It'll buy us time to stop the killings. Nikoladze is broadcasting from an antenna on the roof. That's your first objective. You'll find the rest on your opsat.
Well, so greetings for the Earthlings. Welcome back to more Tom Clancy's Splinter Cell. This level is again an action-packed level. Well, not until the end at least. But yeah, it does involve killing a few people. So let me just go ahead and save here, you know, the save at the beginning of the game. Anyway, so the path is straight up, you just climb over this fence here, and don't really give much thought to anything else. And yeah, you just climb up on this thing here. I'm just going to click save right now, and yeah. So basically, what you want to do is, like for example, that guy turned, right? You don't want that happening. You can risk it right now, but what you want is this guy looking that way and that guy over there not coming here. So, yeah. You can try to waltz over the fence, but it doesn't really make much sense. And yeah, so that's that. So I'm just going to quick save here, and we'll try grabbing this thing. But yeah, that is a success. Damn, Sam, you're noisy. So anyway, moving on. This is how you go. And yeah, that's pretty straightforward. You do not want to take the door here. I think it's locked anyway. What you want to do is go over to the dumpster over there where there's no light, and you want to climb over. That way these guys won't be able to see you. Make sure that these guys aren't looking in your direction when you do that. I'm just going to click save here again. It sort of makes me jump even that guy is, you know, aiming literally right at me, but okay. Whatever helps you sleep at night, I guess. We can jump up from here as well, but we can jump up from here as well.
Carlo, this is Badri. The landmines are in place. Make sure nobody without the polarized thermal sensor enters the courtyard.
Alright, sir. So basically, yeah, the infiltration in this level is pretty straightforward, but did you climb back up, Sam? You're supposed to hang off the thing here. And yeah, let that guy go in. He's still in there. You can't see it. See him using these goggles right now. But here's the thing. These things you see flashing on the ground, these are landmines and you want to avoid them. So avoiding them is a pretty hectic task. But we shall try nonetheless. Yeah. So basically, once you land, you need to press the C button to make sure that that guy can't see you. And there's also a couple of spotlights here which you need to be aware of. So it would be heavily advised that you take that in consideration when you move forward with this level. Just make sure that, you know, you're careful. For example, I did not notice that those guys actually surveilled that area and they caught me. So that was my bad for the most part. Let me try sticking to this wall here. I'm not sure whether that might help or not. Maybe that would, maybe that might not. Yeah, it seems to have helped. They did not see me yet thus far. So anyway, let me just take a quick moment to gather my intelligence and think where to go. No! Yeah. Did you see that lag there? But damn, that was in the nick of time and I'm glad that it was. And I think one of the problems is that I'm not playing with my cooling pad, so... Okay. I'm just gonna stick back here and hope that they don't see me. Okay, is this place... does this road have landmine? There doesn't seem to be one here. I think we can proceed along this route here. There are people patrolling up there, so trying to take the lights out is going to be a little difficult as well. And I think you can't take the lights out either. So yeah, there's that. Just let that light pass, and let's try moving on ahead. There was actually a landmine right there. We can take cover here, I hope. I hope. Okay, so there's one landmine here. There should be another landmine there. So I guess the only way to go forward is by vaulting up onto this crate right here. I don't know what that is. It's probably a crate. So this game is a little, well, nerve-wracking at times. Let's make a break for it. No, you did not. I wonder where you're looking for this person you heard. Is there a landmine here? Yep, there's a landmine right next to me. So I guess the only way up for me is... the only way forward is up. So I guess that's that. I'll just let this light pass and then we shall make our move. Let me just go ahead and quick save here. I hope I did not do that at a wrong point in time. We'll get to know soon enough anyway. Whatever you do, do not go in front of that door. As soon as you do, you will be seen. So there's a guy looking at you from over there as well. Make sure to avoid his gaze. Yeah. Now you're clear to proceed. That door right there, it has got a landmine in front of it. So I'm not sure whether you can access it, interact with it or not. But yeah, the last time I tried, I got blown to bits. So make sure you don't do that. The way you have to go is right up there, and you need to perform a wall jump for that. I don't know why they gave us a medical kit here, but we will need that for the end of the mission, so it's best that we keep it with us. Anyway, I'm just going to update my save here, and I believe it would be a good time for us to read the mission data. Whoops. Oh, hey, they actually give us info on these things. I completely forgot about these. Anyway. Huh. Okay, so this is Vyacheslav Grinko. I think we have seen him before, talking to Philippe Mas. Okay, Vyacheslav Grinko. Numerous known aliases. Excuse me. A Russian citizen, Air of Operations, Georgia, Russia, Eastern Europe, Expetsnaz. Okay, so if you guys want to read this, just go ahead and pause it. Yeah, so a funny story here. The first time I played, first time around I played this level, I, well, basically, the first time around I played any Splinter Cell game, this was my first Splinter Cell game. I was quite, you know, hyped up about just killing everybody. As is the noob, the stealth noob. And I just killed one of those soldiers in the courtyard. And guess what? He had a mail from his wife or girlfriend. I don't remember exactly what it was. But she was asking him when he's going to come home. And she was telling him how worried she is about him. And that letter literally broke my heart to pieces. And that was the time when I made a vow that, you know what, I'm not going to kill anyone in this game anymore. So that's that. Yeah, so basically, this was a well-executed maneuver, to be honest. I didn't expect to get it in just one try. We have to go out here, and the problem with going out here is you want to make sure that you don't step on the tin roof. This place has got to... Let me just go ahead and save again. Yeah, I'll just update the save one. Save, because, you know, it doesn't make sense to save multiple times in the same location. So when you get out here, make sure that you're not, you know, stepping out onto the tin roof, and try to move when the light isn't lit. It shouldn't matter much, but sometimes it does. So yeah.
I want all identifying details stricken from the room. Keep the lights off of the walls. Give them fuller eyelights. We need to clearly see their faces when they die. Where's our sound man? Make sure we're close enough to hear prayers.
I wonder if they can see my shadow, because in the later games like Chaos Theory, they can actually see your shadows, and they react to your shadows, but I don't know about this game though. So I guess this is also a pretty safe spot for us to be. That is a pretty good speed, which you can move on, with which you can move across the roof. So I'm just going to leave it at that.
There's something on the roof. Should we check it out?
It's probably another rat. Don't want to miss the executions.
Precisely. Executions are important, aren't they? You should not miss them. So here's the thing. You want to climb up this gently, I suppose. Because otherwise, those guys seem to see you for some reason. I guess somebody saw me. Maybe I should stick to this side then, where they've got a lesser chance of seeing me. Yep, nobody saw me here. Nice. Right, so once you're over here, just make sure that you save the game. Or if you have already have any saves, just update them. Oh, sorry. So once you're here, just make sure that you save the game, because you might need to go a little faster from this point onwards.
What the hell just happened? The broadcast antenna's down. We've got no outgoing signal.
You're under attack. The Americans are here. They've taken out the broadcast antenna.
Get Nikoladze out of here. I want his helicopter airborne now. I want a squad of technicians with an armed escort on the roof and repairing that antenna. I want the Americans found and killed.
Yes, sir.
Sounds like you shook things up pretty well, but it's only going to buy us a few minutes. Find those soldiers, Fisher.
Let me just equip this beforehand. Let me see how it works out this time around. Let me see if I can stealth through this level. At least this part. Oh, that was easy. Let me just go down here, because just in case that guy over there comes out. So there's a guy in the door to our right. That is also where we need to go. But yeah, let me just stay here for the time being. I fuck up with one of my saves. I don't exactly have to redo it again. I hear a wall mine. Where's the wall mine? It's right there, is it? And I've actually never explored this place before. Let me see, a computer. And I get... Sorry, I did not mean to do that. And I get a wall mine, a frag grenade, and a wall mine, and some data to read. A data stick. To... Levana Vonogradova. To Kaki... Why are these names so difficult to read, man? Gamtsimilze. I don't know how you say that. Just if anybody knows, kindly, you know, put down the pronunciations in the comments. Anyway, subjects. Response to our difficult friends. Kaki. I agree and imagine most Georgians would. I don't trust Feirong or any of his men for that matter. But think of the value to our cause. Think of the weight the Chinese Empire lends our effort. Would the Americans be willing to draw the third largest nation in the world into armed conflict? Into nuclear conflict? Are we approaching the edge? We are approaching the edge, Kaki. Nikoladze and his arc may be able to push us over. He is hoping. Levon. Levon seems a bit nice guy overall. Anyway, so moving on with the level. Why not? Let's just quick save here. I hope I did not do the wrong thing by doing that, but if I did, we can always, you know, like, just redo the entire level. Sort of. Let me just survey the area. There isn't anyone here yet. I mean, there should have been someone here, but right there. I fail to understand how this guy just literally spawns out of nowhere. Just as you enter this room. Smoothly passed. Anyway, moving on. Otherwise, that would have been another guy that we would have had to kill.
We have Nikolaj on board. Estimated departure in.
Estimated departure in. Okay, so basically the locker technique isn't working, so we need to find some alternative technique here. We could probably. So I guess there's only one thing to do here. Just climb up onto this pole and crush whoever is peeing underneath you. And that's the extent of it, I suppose. So, should we? Yeah, I think because he's gonna take forever to wash his hands here. I'm not sure though. Does he move from there? God damn, that is a dirty bathroom. Doesn't anybody ever clean this stuff? Okay, so I should be directly overhead. So basically when you drop down on somebody like that, you don't exactly kill them, but you pretty much destroy them, if you know what I'm saying. Maybe I should, you know, just save you for good luck. Okay. Let's be quick with this. Because I think, yeah, there's another guy gonna be coming from over there who will be interested in us, in our product at least. Okay, that's a weird patrol pattern, but okay. You went your own way. I can certainly admire that. Let me just create a new save here, just in case, because I'm going to try out something. Let me just grab the data stick from this computer, and I suppose we can proceed after that. I wonder where we are to proceed next once this is done.
Gringo, this is Nikoladze. Kill the American soldiers. Take them to the studio and kill them. We'll release the footage whenever we can. Tell Feirong we are moving ahead. I'll retrieve the Ark. This is Gringo. I want the American soldiers prepped and in studio. The executions are going forward as planned.
Let's see if this guy
moves
or decides to move from his place. I can hear somebody else moving about. And that does not give me the creeps at all.
That was Gringo. He wants us to escort the soldiers to the studio.
You copy that, Fisher? The executions are going forward.
I heard. We got any more diversions?
Your gun's full of them. Make sure that escort doesn't reach our troops.
This is Gringo. I want the American soldiers prepped and in studio. The executions are going forward as planned. Yes, sir.
Nice. Oh, seriously. Sometimes this game just doesn't work the way it's supposed to. But
that was
anyway.
Gringo. He wants us.
I'm just gonna quick save here for luck. Take the pipe. Take the tube, basically. And make sure that it moves slow here. Because these are wooden panels for floors. Sorry, for ceilings.
It's not our place to question. Let's go.
And so here's the thing. So basically, you need to drop down from here. But the way always, way isn't always clear. It, I think it usually isn't clear. Let's just go with this here.
What was that?
It's seriously baffling how sometimes, you know, these guys can see you and sometimes they don't. But that was way too much effort for this little stretch of, you know, achieving nothing. But okay, at least I got a satchel or so, I suppose. Yeah, enough trash talk. Paul Hood. Question mark, question mark, question mark. That's the subject line. Paul, Jesus, I don't know. All of our payments have been directly deposited into the accounts they set up for us. I would have said Mars was the person to ask about it, but I've heard he's been killed. Do you know if this is true? Well, it would have been true if, Splinter Cell had a nuclear power plant, this version of Splinter Cell, but he hasn't been killed in this timeline yet. We will be doing that after we kill Nikoladze. Anyway, getting out of Kola seems like a more pressing problem at the moment, though. Do you have any options? Has the cell dissolved entirely? There's got to be a few of our men out there. Maybe some of the locals can help. Do any of them speak English? I can buy you some money if you can find a good place to have it fired to. Jesus, I don't know. Good luck, Leo. Even the mercenaries are trying to escape. I sort of pity these guys now, you know. Their heart wasn't in it, but still they had to die for a cause they did not believe in. Anyway, move on. I'm just gonna update a save. And, oh, another satchel. Nice, it's a medical kit this time. So, here's where things tend to get tricky. Just put on your night vision goggles. Sorry, your thermal goggles. Because, as you can see, this room is full of steam. Or so, I suppose. And the enemy doesn't see you. And you get past him. Whoa, that's blindingly bright. Hopefully he won't be able to see me here. No, I wonder where this machine is, the one that's making all that sound. Right over there, right over there. So we want to stick to the side of the machine. It basically works on the principle of thermals, as we have covered previously. And we just want to make sure that, you know, there does seem to be a short way. I don't know how efficient it is though, but there certainly does seem to be a short way there. Let's see here. Let me just save the game here. Anyway, let me just try to time this thing, I suppose. That might help, I don't know. Interesting. So that was actually surprisingly straightforward. I was just complicating it for myself. Huh. Well, let's just take a break from all the steam, I suppose. And let me just create a new save file here. Hopefully, which won't betray me. So yeah, that save did not betray me. So that was good. I suppose. Let me try this here. This seems to have worked. Okay. Nice. So yeah, for this part you need to be up there, you need to go up there basically. There are three guards here and you can't get past this turret like you did with the previous one. You need to use this pipe to get into the other room. And the only time you can do that is when these guards aren't looking in your way. You did notice me. So I guess I'll just have to take you out first, because I can't literally keep hanging on there for ages on end. Come on over then. Come here. Yeah. Do I get a satchel from you? Yes, I do. And it contains a frag grenade. How amazing. Wow. Okay. So let me try this. I mean, I think I would have gotten a satchel from that guy as well, but who cares? Alright. So I mean, thankfully, I just knocked them out, so you don't need to be worried about that aspect. But yeah, thermogoggles back on, and things should go smoothly from here on out. Yep, the turret did not recognize me, so that is a good sign. There's this person here right above me. I'm debating whether I want to do anything to him or not. But first, I need to deactivate this turret. And this guy doesn't really seem to have much of a patrol path. I seem to be safe here, so might as well just go ahead and create a safe. More like update a safe. This is a rough level. This is no doubt a rough level. And we should just interact with the turret and just deactivate it. That way it won't kill us. Alright then. Let me see here. What? Fine, you can climb up here if you want to. Oh. Nice. Come. Come with me. You need to go somewhere. Somewhere where nobody will find you. I can walk. Yeah. Come. This is going to be your home for the next few days. The other mode is too bright. So how many health kits do we have? Four? One chemical fear, which we could not use, to be honest. What else? Would I like to quick save here? Actually, I would actually prefer to make a new save here, like update my save here. Let's proceed. Because I've actually forgotten the majority of this level, and what I'm playing right now doesn't really feel that Splinter Cell-ish to me for the time being. Quick save. I think there should be another room of steam right up ahead, and seems to be the case thus far. And I wonder if there was somebody that we had to knock out here, because you know, I did that the last time I played it. Come on then. Yeah, unfortunately you just gotta take this guy out, there's no other way around it. Okay, so this is practically the optimal spot for taking this guy out. Anyway, I'm pretty sure there are people who know how to get by this level without taking that guy out, but yeah. For our intents and purposes, we need to. So remind me again. Oh, that's why. Well, that guy does seem to check his surroundings, so maybe we can try this route here. Seems a little darker. Might aid us in our suppose we're good to go. Whew, that guy didn't see us, and that is all well and good. They should not be seeing us. Wait, could I have? Oh no, I couldn't have. Yeah, let me just. There practically isn't anybody else here. I'll just quick save here nonetheless, and we shall drop down here. Wait, where am I supposed to go? Oh, right here. Okay, fine. Come on, Sam. You can do it. You just need to drop down. This fall won't hurt you. Come on, Sam. Oh, come on. Seriously, Sam? Finally, Jesus Christ. Okay, there's nothing here, fine. I'm just gonna go ahead and update the save that I made last time. Actually, I probably should not have done that. That might have been a very wrong move on my behalf, but... huh. What the hell? Doesn't really seem to be anybody here. Doesn't seem like there is anybody here. Okay. Where do we go from here? Oh, we're nearing the end of the first part. Yeah, so basically what we need to do is just activate this thing here, and
nobody's coming,
come on. Yeah, it doesn't really matter how we do that, because that's the end of this level anyway. And yeah, so I wonder if I should just pause my game here and play the next level or on a later date. Because there's still a fair amount of infiltration remaining along with the shootout. At any rate, I'll just go ahead and save here. Yeah. Fine, let me just go ahead and see what this game has to offer. There's somebody there. You just want to be a little aware of them when you move on to this next section, because otherwise they might get you. Nice. That seemed to work, so let me just go ahead and try sticking to this wall here and seeing whether this guy catches us. I hope he does not. He does not. Thus far. Okay, so we can proceed. We are free to proceed. I actually do not want the flare. What I want is to go in here and just quickly get up against this corner so that I can create a save, because I'm no way in hell am I doing that again. But hey, that's basically how it works. You want the guy to come back, the guy who's patrolling, you want him to come back, and he wanted to be his even tune, even number tune, because every second time that he comes back, this guy, he basically, you know, gives a space to proceed, and that's how you want to play it. So anyway, I'm just gonna quick save here, since, you know, this was a job well done. Where are you going? It would be advisable to switch lanes whenever you can, like go over in there, instead of just staying here. I suppose. I'm not sure though. Because yeah, see, right here you've got a wider booth to advance, and up ahead you just don't have that luxury, that wider booth. So you just want to, you know, stay in this area. I think that could have gone a little smoother. Let's see. It sees us too fast, we can't do anything about it. Are you sure you just want to dismiss the sound of gunshots? Seriously, gunshots? Well, I guess, I mean, you fire guns all day, so it must be a pretty routine thing for you, I suppose. Anyway, so I'm just gonna go ahead and I'm just gonna deactivate this turret. And now I think we are. Yeah, sure there is. Hey, wait, so since the turret has been deactivated, what we can do is practically go over here and collect all that we wanted to, or so I suppose. Oh wait, we can take care of against the hay bales, that's nice. Going after the ammo. Five five six, and back up against the hay bale. Are you looking in this direction when all that happens? Yes, you are. And that pretty much is the problem, isn't it? It would seem that not running helped thus far, and let's hope that it stays that way, because I'm practically stuck here.
I'm letting Nikoladze make me paranoid.
Again? You're gonna blame Nikoladze for everything?
What the?
Why is there hostilities music here? Anyway, I've got a health kit, which I should use. Two, actually. Because the time for conflict is quite close. The third data sick, let's read this. David Sakandelidze to Levan Vonogradova. Translation. So, the Chinese ambassadors keep talking to each other in Chinese. This probably isn't surprising, but it makes me worry since we can't understand them. I'm afraid they might be plotting something. Gringo has tried to force Long Dan to translate for us, but so far nothing has worked. And he has done some things which I will soon forget. I was wondering, sir, if we could borrow one of General Feirong's troops for the duration of our stay here to watch over the ambassadors and translate for us if needed. Thank you. Respectfully. David Sakandelidze. Nice name, David. Or so, I suppose. Anyway, this level is a little messy, as it would seem.
They put him on the helicopter. Nikoladze has left us.
Gringo must think the Americans are here.
God help us if they are.
May the gods help you indeed. This one is pretty simple. You just walk up behind it and deactivate it. No biggie. I don't know why the other two were being such morons about it, but okay. Do I want a quick save here? Let's quick save here. Yeah, I just want to deactivate this turret. I do not want to enable the IFF. So I disable the IFF, not the infrared field communication. So if the gas grenades are gonna make you notice me, then I'm afraid I'm just gonna have to use this.
Movement.
Did that take care of both of you? Yes, it did. Nice. This is actually my first time stealthing through this level because when I used to play before this, I was pretty much, you know, reckless. Ha ha ha, you didn't get me. You couldn't get me, you couldn't get me. Alright, you got me. Fine. Since you know. The road is clear, so it would seem. And I doubt there is anybody else who...
That's sick. I'm a soldier, not a sadist.
Come on, you know you want to watch.
I don't! Broadcasting murder is barbaric.
Boy.
You're naive
boy.
To think it's anything but history.
It's a pointless conversation. We're on patrol until the alert flies.
Don't tell me you believe those American super spy stories coming out of Kola.
If Nikoladze believes them, I believe them.
Those stories are nothing but Russian winters and Russian vodka. We should be with the others watching the broadcast.
I'm glad you realize that, I suppose. Good, 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 good. Yeah, let me just go ahead and crawl out of here. And I'll be out here bathing. I doubt there is anybody else here. Doesn't seem to be. And here's the thing. I'll just quick save just in case. Yeah, there it is. So here's where we need to go. This is our final objective, almost. Because once we're in here, what you need to do is take out all these lights in advance. And just so that you can create shadows for yourself, I'm just going to save the game here. How to save too.
Okay.
Can we take those lights off? No, we cannot. So, right. So, let me just deactivate this turret first. Yeah. And let me just go ahead and talk with the American soldiers. Oh, health kit. I sorely needed that, to be honest. Sounds about right. Yeah, Americans, yeah.
Grinko wouldn't let them torture us. He kept saying we had to look pretty for our execution.
We haven't eaten in 2 days. I'm not sure I can walk.
You've come to save us. Where are the others?
It's just me.
Oh, crap.
too bad these guys don't know Sam Fisher. Alright, so reactivate this turret. Actually, it's wise to reactivate both turrets once you can make your way ahead. Because these turrets are practically going to save your life. So, yeah. Let me just... I'm not going to quick save yet. But what I will do is, before entering this room, I'm going to override the save. And...
You are American.
You're Chinese.
The PRC ambassador to Myanmar. I must speak with a representative of your government.
They hear everything I do. Shoot.
Kong Feirong does not represent the will of China. He is a splinter faction of the Chinese army. All of them fanatics and fools.
What does he want?
First, Taiwan, with others to follow. Gifts to the PRC he thinks they will not be able to refuse.
How is Nikoladze involved?
Trade. Feirong provides transport and munitions in exchange for weapons-grade nuclear waste.
Does China know?
No. And unless they are issued proof of Feirong's activities, I fear the certainty of war.
What's the proof?
On the computer in his office. My office. He has overridden and reset the lock.
I force him to open his computer and forward the contents to the PRC. And our countries don't go to war.
Such is my hope.
Okay, so...
The Americans are picking the pistol. I want all available men armed to converge on the base. We'll kill them all.
Yeah, just... I hope nobody checks a grenade in here, because they seem rather fond of doing that for some reason.
No, please don't! Help us! They're gonna kill us!
Oh my god! Oh man! I completely forgot. It's a good thing I made the save here. So basically, I forgot to do the most elementary of steps. You need to disable the IFF. Yeah.
But
the Americans are picking the basement. I want all available men armed to converge on the basement. We'll kill them all.
Let's hope they don't throw grenades in here. And yeah, let's just sit back there and enjoy the fun. Have fun.
Help! Oh god, don't let us die!
How did you know I was here?
Colonel Bagrat, report! Colonel Bagrat! Death mission. I'm going down there. The Franco, you're coming with me.
Fisher, kill Franco. His men are mercenaries. Their only cause is money and intimidation.
So, once Franco's dead, they scatter.
Let's hope so.
So, and that is the guy that we need to kill. Vyacheslav Grinko. Okay, fine. I got your point. And that's the end of the game. At the level, at least.
Vicious Grinko is dead!
Vicious Love, okay.
Fisher, Echelon just picked out an intercept. Feirong knows that Grinko's dead and Nikoladze is gone.
That's not good.
Get back to the embassy. He's trying to destroy the evidence that could keep us out of a war.
Right.
Mouke Tsoe Bo Meats, Yangon, Myanmar, November 11, 2004, 23:57 hours. I forgot what time we started the infiltration. I think it was somewhere around 2100 hours. Anyway, the rescue of the US troops and Chinese dignitaries has momentarily stabilized faltering US-Chinese relations. The Chinese dignitaries claim that Feirong represents only a splinter faction of the PLA operating without the knowledge of Greater China. Proof that Feirong has gone renegade could prevent an impending war. And that is where the heroes come in to save the day. So I'm pretty sure he's a hero in this regard. Well, yeah, so the thing you just saw here, this is the second time that this is happening. After Kalin attack, that is. If we hadn't hidden back in, what was the first mission again? No, not the first mission. I think it was the second mission. Yeah, Georgian Defense Ministry. Over there as well, mission number two, mission number five, and mission number seven now. They all have shootouts at the end, and it seems to be sort of a recurring theme with this game, because they are only going to get more and more frequent after this. We're going to have a shootout at Georgian Palace as well, and we are going to, have a shootout in the levels in practically all the three levels after that. So, yeah, that's one of the things which I dislike about this game, but it is what it is, I suppose. Sometimes this game just forces you into conflict, and that's cool. It's the way this game is built. But those factors are exactly why I do not wish to consider this to be a true stealth game. But anyway, this level was a long one, and I was debating whether or not to, split into two parts. I'll leave the decision up to editing Grimfangs. So yeah, up until then, until next time, see you guys, take care, farewell fellow Earthlings.